Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this small race here of the URD EGT mod at Indianapolis GP 2014. My name is Ricardo Edelman. I'll be a commentator tonight. With me here is Xavier de Carvalho. I hope that I pronounced it right. And we'll commentate this race for you. Currently, we are in the formation lap of this race. It just started. For the positions, you can see it. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this small race here of the. And I just realized I didn't turn off the sound of this pre-stream here. On the left, you can see all positions given at the moment. As we have one guy who just drove into the grass. And we can see it on the replay here. He just went straight on.
Yeah, yes. I think that was actually Oscar Hardwick who had done that, Ricardo. If we want to go through the grid quickly, we can do that. I'll take you through the first, well, the only 26 drivers in this race. Unfortunately, we've already had the disconnect. It's unfortunate. Rene Reitero out of this race already. But on pole position is Oscar Hardwick. Came in late on the server. And, well, completely dominated qualifying. Pole position. Second, we've got Stephen Bailey. Then Christian Michel, the Virtual World Series Barreno Clio Cup champion, is in third position. Fourth position, we have Adam Hodgkinson. In fifth, Miroslav Davidovic. In sixth, Shel Stanbeck. Seventh, Alexei Kivela. He was part of the winning team in the Virtual World Endurance Championship, so you can expect him to do well here today. We've got April Dillon in eighth place, the Le Mans 2.5-hour winner. Then in ninth place, we've got Anders Nielsen. 10th, Yuri Kuzdorp. In 11th, Matt Richards. 12th, Luka Oslakovic. In 13th, Fors Schelotto. In 14th, Magnus Dahlgren. 15th, we've got Davy van der Ven, the in-house movie maker for race department. In 16th, we've got René Yves and Jean Charles. 17th, Theo van den Brink. In 18th, Henrik Lek. 19th, Ek Simpson. 20th, Roman Golli. In 21st, Damir Dubaric. In 22nd, Fabio Russo. 24th, Stefan Woudenberg, and in 25th, Franklin Stedjink. As the cars all come out to their positions on the grid, well, we've got a second disconnect there. That's unfortunate for René Yves, Jean Charles. We're waiting for the lights to come on. We'll see who gets the better start between the two leaders.
And Oscar we'll Hardwick just and see Bailey. The start from the cockpit view of Christian Michel in the second row here.
And the lights are all on and around, and we are away here. The EGT. The first club race for the EGT Zero Race Department here at Indianapolis on the 2013 Grand Prix layout. And Oscar Hardwick getting a brilliant start down into turn one. He's already got a really small gap to Stephen Bailey. Miroslav Davidovic has jumped up to third position. Christian Michel down to fourth. Oh, and there's a little bit of argy-bargy stuff going on towards the mid-pack there. Davy van der Ven getting chased down by Oslakovic and Theo van den Brink trying to go around the outside of him. Back at the front though, Oscar Hardwick charging away there.
Many overtakes here in the first few corners, but it seems like everything's okay. No one left the track. I took on the grass, so everything should be fine. It seems like Oscar Hardwick is just pulling away there a bit from Stephen Bailey.
You got to wonder what tyres he's chosen to start this race on, whether he's started on the sprint tyres or the endurance tyres. Obviously, the sprint tyres will give you a couple tenths of a second edge per lap over the rest of the competition if they're on the endurance tyre. And obviously, the endurance tyre, a little bit less grip, but they do, of course, last longer. Well, actually, Stephen Bailey's right on the back of Oscar Hardwick down on the main straight. We'll see. He's gone right past him. Wow. I wonder what's...
It looked like Oscar was a bit too slow there in this last few corners. Very technical section there. And I just saw we have two guys on out of track. They were... It seems like they were... in the gravel pit or something like that. We'll replay this for a second.
Matt Richards going right up the inside of Alexei Kivela into turn one. Kivela having to take slightly evasive action there. Good pass from Matt Richards there on Covella.
We just saw Alexi Kivila running a bit wide there on the last corner. Just over the line. Shouldn't do that too much. Maybe the marshals will review this if this happens too often.
Yeah, cutting, of course, is heavily frowned upon within the community. And the administrators will most definitely be keeping a keen eye out for cutting. Oh, but a massive gaggle of cars here. Great racing. Is Theophan and Brink trying to cut the inside of David van der Ven, and he doesn't get it done. Oh, but he's still trying to go around the outside. That is brave stuff from Van den Brink. Whoa, David van der Ven slightly wide out of that, coming into Sector 2. But up at the front is Oscar Hardwick and Stephen Bailey going head to head for the lead of this race. Just 0.3 of a second separating the two. Looks as though Stephen Bailey's got the legs on him down the straights, though. He's just got a much better exit coming out of that second to last corner. And, giving the edge down the straight, must be said.
And he just did the best lap for this race so far.
Yep, and he's 1 minute 36.8, so it's almost 2 seconds off his qualifying time. But obviously with a full tank of fuel, and it seems like endurance tires on that car, those kinds of times are to be expected, and they will drop the further down we head. Now we're expecting a one-stop race, so maybe when the guys are on fresher tires and on lower tanks of fuel, we should see the times dropping a bit. We've got Christian Michel right on the back of Adam Hodgkinson. See if he can make a move. Well, Christian Michel's actually lost out quite a bit there. He started on the second row of the grid, and he's now finding himself down in seventh place. So I wonder what had happened to Christian Michel for him to have dropped down so far from where it started. Oh, and he's trying to muscle his way past Adam Hodgkinson again. And they do trade positions, but oh, now Kivela's right at the inside of Christian Michel, and we'll see if he can get a good run out of the second-to-last corner. No, he doesn't, and Christian Michel takes the position back, but he's got... Sorry, Kivela's now got April Dillon on the back of him. There's a three-car battle here, soon to be what it looks to be a five-car battle, with Magnus Dahlgren and Yuri Kozlov coming next to them. April Dillon now going to make a move on Kivela and Christian Michel into turn one. She thinks better of it, and, lets them all through. But Kivela's the one who's come out on top there. Gone straight past Hodgkinson. Oh, he's given the positions back, though. I wonder if he had cut the track. Didn't see that. Now Christian Michel making a move on Hodgkinson. We'll see what he can do here. Gets around him. Oh, Hodgkinson going very slowly. Next out of the corner, and we've got a spinner.
We got a spinner.
Very, very close from Yuri Karsdorp.
Maybe
just
we can
got it wrong
see that
the
again.
Exit of the corner there. Yeah, looks like he just got it wrong on the exit of the corner there, and sent him into a half spin. He's lucky to be able to get going again. Could have ended a lot worse than what it did. But the leaders again, Oscar Hardwick and Stephen Bailey. Just 0.4 of a second over that last split. But obviously you can see Oscar Hardwick right on the tail of Stephen Bailey. These two are probably going to be at each other's throats right up until the first pit stop. And Miroslav Davidovic not too far behind, although he has fallen 3 seconds down the road. Not sure if maybe he's fuel saving or trying to look after his tires a little bit better than the two front runners are.
Magnus Dahlgren just overtook April Dillon here, getting the position 8, but there's already...
Look at the gaggle of cars here.
And there's already attack, and April seems to get it again. No, she lost it.
Magnus Dahlgren around the outside into turn one, but just behind him, Kvyat and Oslakovic are going at each other's throats as well.
Yeah.
Brilliant racing so far, and it's only been, what, 10 minutes of 1.5 hours? And now Oslakovic right on the back of April Dillon. Will he try and make a move now on her into the... Oh, he gets off onto the dirt and nearly slams into the back of her. That was very close from him. But Kvyat looks to be struggling a little bit behind these guys. I wonder if the dirty air isn't having a negative effect on his vehicle. We've got Anders Nielsen behind him as well. Pack is still closely... you know, they're still in a tight pack, very close together, these guys.
And there was an attack from Luka Oslakovic, and he got April Dillon as well.
Oh, wow, very
just
good stuff.
Just on the inside, yeah. Late on the brakes, and he got it.
Good overtaking move there from Oslakovic, but I'm sure April Dillon will not be too happy about that. She will definitely be wanting to maybe get herself back past him and try and advance up the field as much as she can. But Matt Richards, wow! Matt Richards up in 6th position after starting a little bit lower down in the field. That's not something to sneeze at. Christian Michel got himself back up into 5th position, chasing down Shell Stanbeck, who also didn't start as high as 4th position and made his way up the grid. Miroslav Davidovic still in 3rd, and Oscar Hardwick still trying to chase down Stephen Bailey. Yeah, and Bailey definitely getting a much better run out of that second-to-last corner. Oh, sorry, that wasn't even the second-to-last corner. Getting a little bit disoriented here with this circuit. Looks so similar through Sector 2 as it does in Sector 3. But just look at the exit that Bailey has coming onto some of the faster sweeping corners. Just leaving Oscar Hardwick behind in her in his dust, should I say. we've also still Miroslav Davidovic in 3rd. But he's dropping back quite heavily. So I wonder if Oscar and Steven didn't opt for the softer compound of the two tyres, the sprint tyres, or maybe for a little bit less fuel for their, to make it just their first pit stops, which could explain why they're running, well, kind of running away with this race so far. Shell Stanback still leading from Christian Michel with a not such a hefty gap. I think it's about 2 seconds between Shell Stanback, and then Christian Michel has a 2 second gap, so even numbers there between himself and Matt Richards. And Adam Hodgkinson looks like he's got around Magnus Dahlgren. Magnus Dahlgren still got Oslakovic right on his tail. So some brilliant battles forming here just in the early stages of the race. And let's hope that it carries on throughout the full 1.5 hours that we have here tonight. A little bit further back, we've got Franklin Stejink trying to make a move on Davy van der Ven. We'll see. They're very, very close together. Now, Theophan and Brink is actually closing down on their little group here. So we'll see if maybe they can make it a three-car battle. And indeed, they can, because Van den Brink, tries to go...
Barely missed him, yeah.
Franklin Stejink. That was close. Franklin Stejink, of course, race winner in the Virtual World Series Barreno Clio Cup. So he's no stranger to the top half of the grid, must be said. But I'm sure he wouldn't appreciate that move from Van den Brink. He'll remember that one. But Kvyat leading this train of cars. It's Kvyat, Anders Nielsen, Davy van der Ven, Franklin Stejink, and Theo van den Brink all fighting for that 11th place spot, just outside the top 10. In fact,
besides
we've got April Dillon on the back of Aldrin. See if she can make a move up on the inside. She's about to go for the overtake. Can she make it stick? Oh, there's nearly contact, and April Dillon, she's spun, and she's parked herself in the middle of the corner and she's just been whacked by Anders Nielsen. April. Ah, she will not be happy with herself there. Silly, silly mistake from April there. Just unfortunate for the cars coming through, unable to avoid her. She was parked in the middle of the circuit. Just couldn't get that move done on Magnus Dahlgren, and he kind of closed the door on her there, and I don't think she was expecting it, but yeah, it's a tough one to call that.
She's trying to crawl back to the pits, I think. Her car looks really wrecked. Will be
now hopefully she can get that car repaired and into a more drivable state. I know she is one of the few who does in fact enjoy finishing the race more than leading or winning. So you can be sure that she's definitely going to try and limp back to the pits, see if she can fix the damage and try and finish the rest of this race. But it's unfortunate so early on that she's had to, that she has sustained damage. But a little bit further forward, we've got Davy van der Ven and Roman Goli going at each other here. And Goli, just getting out of the way of van der Ven, looking a little bit better there. Oh, but van der Ven, I did not notice this, but van der Ven is missing the whole front splitter of his vehicle, and he does come into the pit, so he's going to be... who's behind him? That's Anders Nielsen, I think. Anders Nielsen coming into the pits as well, who I think made the initial contact with April Dillon as she was beached, or parked, is the right word, in the middle of a circuit in turn one. We'll see if she's going to make it. Yes, she comes back into the pits as well. So now it's going to be the battle, for those three at least, the battle of the pit crews.
Gael Stenbeck and Christian Michal are pretty close together here. Maybe Christian Michal can get him on this long straight, but it doesn't seem like that.
Yeah, well, Christian Michal has definitely closed the gap a lot, and so has Matt Richards, in fact. And bear in mind, Christian Michal had dropped down to 7th, so he's made up 2 positions, and he's now chasing down for 4th position. And he will then definitely be making a charge to try and catch Miroslav Davidovic in that Ferrari. But Christian Michal, one of the quickest guys on the grid here today. Obviously, the winner of the Virtual World Series by Renault Clio Cup, so he's no stranger to being at the front of the pack. And, definitely not a stranger to the top step of the podium. Of course, also a race winner in the Virtual World Series by Renault.
Oh, and I just see Stephen Bailey and Oscar Hardwick. Oscar Hardwick just attacks Stephen Bailey.
Wow, and they were very lucky to come away.
Yeah, pretty close there.
But very good stuff nonetheless. Oscar Hardwick, also a race winner here in the Virtual World Series by Renault, Formula Renault 3.5 Championship, in fact. So he's also no stranger to the front of the grid. And I think I said this earlier on today, just before the race, that we have, or we must have at least, 5 or 6 guys who are all capable of taking the win here today. But of course, Oscar Hardwick and Stephen Bailey proving to be the class of the field at the moment. Stephen is a newcomer to the clubs here at race department. And, proving his worth, must be said. But Oscar Hardwick not making it easy for him.
Just as a comparison here, the lap times of the three guys in front of the field, Stephen Bailey, is his best lap time is only 7/1000ths of a second slower than Oscar Hardwick's time. He has the best time at the moment. The last lap, Stephen Bailey was about 2/10ths of a second faster than Oscar Hardwick.
Oh, sorry, I just need to interrupt you. We've got our first DNF. Magnus Dahlgren has DNF'd. I want to see if we can try and see what he had done there. He just slowed his car right down. See if I can see on the replay what he had done.
It was it? Magnus Dahlgren?
Yeah, Magnus Dahlgren is out of the race, unfortunately for him. He was ahead of Alexei Kivela. Looked to be going strong, and then all of a sudden just slowed his car right down and, exited the race.
I have no event over this. Maybe it was just a disconnect or something like that.
Yeah, no, he definitely parked his car right on the left-hander, just as you come down into Sector 2. And, DNF for him, but that gives Davy van der Ven, Anders Nielsen, and April Dillon a chance to go at least one position higher in the field. And, unfortunately... They're one lap down already. Oh, Kjell Stenbeck is also out of the race. So Wonder what you
I have
done.
A replay over that one. I'll try to get it.
Yeah, Christian Michel right on his tail, so... Whoa,
Matt
someone
Richards.
Just
Matt Richards, DNF.
Matt Richards with a massive spin coming out of the second to last corner. Straight into the wall. You will be disappointed with himself there, but I think Christian Michel and Kjell Stenbeck might have had some contact into turn one. Just have a look here. No. So what did Shell do? Oh, he spun.
Yeah, Kjell Stenbeck just spun there and parked his car and instantly just DNF'd.
Hmm. Strange stuff from Kjell Stenbeck. So three cars out in the space of one lap. We're back at the front. Stephen Bailey and Oscar Hardwick still going toe-to-toe, and they're about to come and lap April Dillon, who, well, seems like she's got that car fixed. Oh, never mind. Power sliding into that corner. Still missing part of her front splitter, so obviously the pit crew not doing their best job. We'll see if Oscar Hardwick can try and make a charge over the next couple of laps to take the lead again. Or starting from pole position. Miroslav Davidovich still trailing around in third position. Just 14 seconds down the road already. He's got Christian Michel closing the gap to him. So Christian Michel just one position down from where he started the race. Of course, after he had been bumped down to seventh. Back up in fourth and now charging to get that final podium spot. Now Zlakovic and Van der Ven are still having a go at each other. And Van der Ven still... Oh, sorry. He was lapping Van der Ven, in fact. Van der Ven still has a substantial amount of damage on the front of his car. Doesn't look like they were able to repair the splitter. And, well, in fact, if April Dillon does get lapped on this lap, that will put her two laps down. So she will be kicking herself for the mistake that she had made into turn one. But a little bit further back, if we can look down for the battle, sorry, for... 11th position, sorry, 12th position. We've got Yuri Kasdorp,
Henrik Lek.
And Henrik Lek.
Yeah, but Yuri seems to have a small gap there behind him. Doesn't look like Henrik Lek can get there easily.
Yeah, man, I think. Sorry, that was a delay. Yuri Kasdorp did, in fact, get ahead of Henrik Lek there. But now Henrik has X Simpson right on the back of him. So racing throughout, no matter where you are, there is racing going on. But there's a battle forming, or about to form, between Franklin Stejink and Alexei Kivela. Kivela seems to be struggling today. It's really not like him. The, of course, one of the members of the winning team of the Virtual World Endurance Championship. So, a very, very strange to see him down in seventh position. Maybe a little bit of practice, or not enough practice, should I say, was an issue. Zakovic getting around.
We have one
to lap him.
We have someone, Jeffmaster3, Jeffmaster just said, problem with the mod is the cars aren't balanced. I didn't drive the mod that much, so I can't really respond on that. What do you say about that, Xavier?
Well, I mean, I've been driving this mod, you know, ever since it had come out, pretty much, and it was very unbalanced in the beginning. However, you know, with the last couple of updates... They have actually managed to close the gap between all of the cars again. And at least for myself, I can see, especially, well, if you have a look at this grid, you've got almost every single car, you know, and unfortunately the BMW, the only BMW here, had crashed. So we can't really judge his performance in this race. But, I mean, we've got a grid full of Corvettes, Porsches and Ferraris. In fact, the Corvette is in first position now. Hardwick got ahead of Stephen Bailey, must have been through traffic. We've got a Corvette in first, a Porsche in second. And a Ferrari in third, and an Aston Martin in fourth. So pretty much every single one of the manufacturers locking out a top four spot. So I don't know. These things seem balanced to me.
Yeah, it looks like it's balanced here.
Oh, speaking of the leaders, we've got Stephen Bailey going right up the inside of Oscar Hardwick. Oh, does he muscle his way past? Oh, slight tag on Oscar Hardwick there. But he does back out of it, so... Very courteous
driving.
In
the traffic, it gets
Russo in the way. Unfortunate for Oscar. That gives Bailey a good run down the front, the front straight, should I say.
Yeah, and it's pretty difficult now in this traffic to try to defend your position, because you have to watch out for the guy behind you, and you have to watch out that you don't hit the guy in front of you.
Yeah.
It's always easier to drive behind the leader in the...
Four spinners, Fun and Brink.
Two spinners in one corner there.
Fun and Brink, and... Ooh, and Fun and Brink's car looks a little bit, not happy, let's say. Spinning a little bit there. Hopefully he can get back to the pits and whatever damage happened there. Oh, Van der Ven is back in the pits, unfortunately for him. Obviously he realized that they didn't do a good enough job the first time around to fix his car. And he's on his way again.
And as I said, it's always easier to be behind the leader or behind the guy in front of you and just in traffic, because you can easy take some opportunities if this guy makes a mistake while lapping others. So it's always easier.
Sorry, we have Yuri Kozlov going right or trying to make a move on Henrik Lek. Henrik Lek has spun. Oh, just went in. Oh, sorry, he half spun. Managed to save it. Good save, Henrik Lek. Unfortunately, not really unfortunate, but he just decided to take the corner a little bit too quickly and forced him into half spin. We've now got another car in the pits, and that's Stefan Woudenberg in his Aston Martin. So, I wonder if we're going to see any more pit stops. Of course, we're now, I think, 40 minutes into this race.
Yeah, we are 40 minutes into this race.
And, been very, very busy here and racing all around. Oh, and in fact, Franklin Stejink on the back of Alexei Kivela and Oslakovic, and these guys, Oslakovic locking up into the corner there and allowing Kivela through, and Franklin Stejink takes advantage of it. No, he don't just, think Oslakovic is going to appreciate being whacked like that. And he, of course, takes a dive into the pits.
But Stejink, so many, many overtakes here on this track at the moment.
Yeah, and we were worried that we weren't going to be seeing enough of this.
Yeah.
April Dillon still trying to nurse the car home. 40 minutes into the race and she's still there after her early incident. Anders Nielsen also without the whole...
And we have a yellow flag in the first sector at the moment.
Ooh, I wonder who that was. I just skipped past him now. I think it was Adam Hodgkinson.
Yeah, it was Adam Hodgkinson.
Had a slight spin there.
Yeah, he just misbraked and had to go straight, stop, and wait for the others to pass to get back on track.
We've actually seen that quite often in this race so far, where guys are out breaking themselves down into turn one and unfortunately sending themselves into a half spin. And we saw the same we saw it earlier on with April Dillon, who would try to make a move on Magnus Dahlgren, and unfortunately caused that massive accident. But you know, like I say, we've seen that happen. I'm just going to interrupt myself. I've just seen Stefan Woudenberg pulling out of the pits only now, a whole two laps down on the rest of the field, Stefan Woudenberg. So that was a lengthy pit stop. There's a massive lockup ahead of him. And another accident. What is going on with these guys?
Who was it?
It was Christian Michel, Miroslav Davidovic, making a move on Dubaric. He was trying to lap Dubaric, I think. He got around him safely. And then Christian Michel, Miroslav Davidovic had spun going into the corner, a little bit too hot into the corner, and had a half spin. And Christian Michel just tagged him. So Davidovic Gives third position, that final podium spot, to Christian Michel, so he's going to have to work hard to get it back. He will be kicking himself, however, at that. Just giving up third position so easily.
Alexi Kivela and Franklin Stegg in close battle here. Only a few meters between those two cars at the moment. And we have yellow flag in all three sectors at the moment.
What is
and
going on?
That's the second and the third sector. And we have some other guys just going off track, I see here. Adam Hodgkinson again.
This could be all. Yeah, Hodgkinson. Another spin.
You just spun out there.
I wonder if the tires aren't going for these guys. I think it's time to head into the pits, boys. And Shalotto trying to get his way around Heck. Sorry, Leck, not Heck. And things better.
Fabio Russo also had us just spun out there.
Oh, too sure what's going on. I'm leaning towards the. I've got a suspicion that these guys' tires are not lasting as long as they were expecting them to last, and maybe we'll see a two-stop, although it's unlikely since we're already more than halfway through.
Yuri Castro, right on the back of Adam Hodgkinson at the moment.
Oh, wow, look at that. But look just behind him, Henrik Leck, Phil Schelotto, and David van der Ven getting himself in there, although he is a lapped car, comes into the pits.
Maybe at the end of the straight, Yuri can take this opportunity. But the gap seems like it's too big there.
With Phil Schelotto on Leck. See if Phil Schelotto can get past Henrik Leck. Oh, no.
Almost.
Not late enough on the brakes there. Of course, he's seen a couple of guys spin themselves around trying to move like that, so thinking better of it. Miroslav Davidovich is in the pits for a very long time. In fact, he's just gone a full lap down. So after being in third position, he's now way back down in 13th. Full 10 positions that he's lost. And Oscar Hardwick is still leading this race by over 1.5 seconds.
So Alexi Kivela and Franklin Stegging again.
These guys are really close to each other.
On the entry of the last section of the track, pretty close together.
Well, let's see if Stegging gets a good run out of the second to last corner and if he can make a move into turn one. Just to finish my point on Oscar Hardwick and Stephen Bailey, I think these guys are managing their tires very, very well. And, still got some very decent pace. Still in the low 37s and the high 36s, these guys. But let's see, Stegging not close enough. Oh, sorry. Sorry, I think, who is he backing with? I've just lost myself. Nope, sorry, Kivela is still there. Sorry, I couldn't see you on my screen. Thought Kivela had maybe pulled into the pits.
No, Kivela is still in front of Franklin Stegging here, on fourth position.
Yeah, and Stegging is still closing in on him. We'll see if he can make a move going down towards the Sector 2. Oh, Stegging a little bit sideways under that corner, it looks like. Davidovich is still in the pits. I wonder what he's done. He's going to be really kicking himself. Really kicking
Xavier?
Himself for that. Yeah, and he's out of the pits now. So a very lengthy pit stop for Miroslav Davidovich there.
I'll just quickly turn up the volume of the cars for the audience. And we're back.
Right, and Stegging. Good run out of the second to last corner, but not as good as Kivela. We'll see if he can maybe make a move into turn one. I doubt it. He might be able to close the gap slightly. Whoa, he's having a peek. Maybe just to look at where his braking point is. Very difficult when you're following someone that close to pinpoint your braking spot. And I was going to say earlier that maybe some of those incidents were down to some of the lap traffic. Could very well be the case. I myself, when racing in endurance series and stuff, have had my fair share of incidents due to the back markers. Oh, Oscar Hardwick got a massive cut there. Hopefully he lifted. Otherwise he's going to have to serve a penalty sometime soon.
Just a small comparison between Franklin Stegging, Alexi Kivila and Roman Goli. Last lap, Franklin Stegging 139.218. 1/10 of a second faster than Alexi Kivila and 1.7 seconds faster than Roman Goli the last lap. So these guys are, I think, faster than, much faster than the guys behind them. But compared to each other, they are pretty equal, as it seems like. Because yeah, the best laps of both aren't that far.
Oh, he's about to make a move on Goli. Sorry, he's about to make a move on Goli. Adam Hodgkinson, will he make it stick? Coming into the final complex of corners, and he has made it stick. Oh, and Goli with a massive lockup. That's not going to do your tires any good, my friend. And that's allowed Yuri Kuzdorf to close right on the back of him. And now with a good run out of the second to last corner, he can take the position from Roman Goli as well. Now Hodgkinson is just going to be looking in his mirrors and praying that those two get into a battle so that he can run away with it. Owen Kuzdorf right up the inside of Roman Goli. I wonder. Goli seemed to be very long on the brakes there. His tires are also starting to give up. All those lockups are starting to have their effect as he locks up yet again.
I don't know what happened exactly to Henrik Lek, but he did not finish. He was just about making a pit stop. Was standing there in the pits and just got reset back to the box.
Yeah, so I wonder if maybe he hadn't sustained maybe too much damage and it would have taken too long for him to fix. And, well, he felt like this wasn't worth hanging around, which is unfortunate. You've got girls, such as April Dillon, and you've got Miroslav Davidovich and Stefan Woudenberg even. Got two laps down and still trying to finish the race. As we're now just past the 1 hour mark into this race, we've got another half an hour to go. Oh, and Stephen Bailey's got past Oscar Hardwick. I didn't even see where that move came from, but Oscar must have made a mistake and allowed Bailey through. And the gap between those two leaders to Christian Michel in third position is now 33 seconds.
Now we're currently watching the overtake of of Stephen Bailey. And yeah, it was just a mistake from Oscar Hardwick, who just got a bit on the grass there, had to lift the throttle, letting Stephen Bailey through.
And we've got Damir Dubaric in the pits as well now. Very, very, very long pit stops here today. Longer than we've seen in most races. And, well, how's this? The leaders have lapped everyone up until 10th position. Oh, as I say that, Oscar Hardwick having a very difficult time getting past Eck Simpson. And Eck Simpson being very aggressive towards Oscar Hardwick. They're not letting, he's definitely not adhering to blue flags and not letting the leader through. That was a strange occurrence.
The Alexi Kivila and Franklin Stegging still close together there. I think these two guys are the perfect example for what we thought how the race would look like. They are following each other closely, but there's no overtake going on.
Oh, and Nick Simpson coming into the pits now. Wonder if he doesn't have a penalty after holding up the leader like he did and causing incidents with the leader. Yep, and it looked like a stop and go for Rick Simpson. So unfortunate for him. But that's what you get when you don't adhere to the blue flags. It's very clear in the rules, and I doubt Oscar Hardwick's going to appreciate being held up the way he was. And the gap now between Oscar Hardwick and Stegging.
And Alexei Kivila and Franklin Stegging exactly the same time into the pits. This will be a close pit battle now here.
This is going to be... This is the race right here. This battle for fourth and fifth.
We'll stay with Alexei Kivila here for this pit stop.
Oh, and he's taking a long time. And he... Oh, they're now working on the rear of the car. He's changing all of his tires and putting in quite a bit of fuel. Christian Michel's in the pits as well. I didn't realize that.
Yeah, oh, he's just in between those two at the moment.
Yep, he's away now. As is Alexei Kivela, I think. No, Kivela's still stuck in the pits. So he's steadying.
As well as Franklin.
So. Wow.
And now he goes off.
There goes Kivela. Roman Goli coming to the pits just as Kivela leaves. So, lucky for him.
Perfect timing.
And Stejink is gone now as well. Oh, and he's ahead of Kivela. That's
lucky,
important.
Lucky.
That is important for this battle. So I wonder if... Stejink held out on any of the changes or anything, or if he didn't put enough fuel in, or maybe...
Oscar Hardwick now also in the pits.
Oh, yeah.
And Christian Michel just passed those two with his pits up.
I think he was already in third position. But Hodgkinson up in fourth with Kuzdorp right on the back of him.
Okay, and, Christian Michel,
coming down as well.
Just to see the pit stops, at the moment, Stephen Bailey, no pit stops. Oscar Hardwick is the first time at the moment in the pits. Christian Michel has two pit stops.
Whoa, Oscar Hardwick is... Oh, he was rolling in the pits, so he was unaware that the pit crew had released him. Rolling down the pits and then suddenly realized, oh, maybe I should get going. That's also going to be quite important because... The battle between Oscar Hardwick and Stephen Bailey is a very intense one, and this is for the lead of the race, of course. We'll see if Oscar Hardwick was able to jump Stephen Bailey, who's actually coming down the start-finish straight now. You see, I get very disoriented. This is why infield tracks and an oval is a difficult one to commentate on, because everything looks the same when they get onto the outfield. But we'll see if Oscar Hardwick was able to make a jump on Stephen Bailey with that pit stop, and Bailey not opting to pit this time round. So he's going to go as long as he can. I wonder if he's going to try and do the entire race without any stops. His tires seem perfectly fine. His looks to have enough fuel at the moment, so maybe, he can go the full distance. Oh, and the gap between Stejink and Kivela is growing quite a lot. So, that pit stop made quite a difference there with their battle. As Kivela now has to negotiate his way around the back marker of Davy van der Ven. Very unfamiliar territory for Davy. He's more used to being up at the front. And Christian Michel trying to negotiate his way around the back marker as well. He gets well out of his way, but he adheres nicely to the blue flags and lets him pass.
I just heard that Oscar stalled his car in the pits, and that's why he lost time there. He had to restart the car.
Oh, and Oscar with another cut. Sorry, speaking of Oscar. with another cut in turn one. So he'll have to be careful of that. If he does it too often, he might find himself with a stop-and-go penalty. And Bailey trying to negotiate his way around some more traffic. He's not making it easy for him either. Let's hope that they're sensible. Now Shalotto still ahead of Nielsen. Where is Nielsen? I guess Nielsen is two laps down, so a lot of cars who have been lapped not once but twice. From 14th right down to 19th. They've all been lapped not once but twice so far. And everyone up until 6th position has been lapped at least one lap. So those leaders definitely trying to prove some sort of a point.
And it looks like that that Adam Hodgkinson will be lapped in a few seconds too. Stephen Bailey's right behind him. And
that was close. Really close. That was really, really close.
I think one of Bailey's holes on his body might have tightened there.
Yep.
Oh, you can see Bailey's tires are starting to go away slightly. You can see him not really power sliding, but the rear end of that car looks a little bit unhappy going into the corners and giving him a little bit of a slide on entry. And of course, these cars do have a very soft front end, so sliding is natural to these cars, and obviously with really worn out rear tires, that effect gets magnified.
Okay, and we have some Stephen Bailey fans here in the chat at the moment. Jimmy Ropan just wrote, Bailey, he's our man. If he can't do it, no one can. So, maybe that helps Stephen Bailey to win this race here.
Well, I'm certainly rooting for him right now. I mean, Oscar Hardwick, as well as he's done today, doesn't seem... He's got a 55-second gap to try and close down on Stephen Bailey.
Yeah, but he pitted. Stephen Bailey didn't pit.
If Stephen doesn't pit at the end of the race, before the end of the race, Oscar's going to have a very difficult time trying to make that gap up again.
Oh, and there was another spin in front of Stephen Bailey there.
Wow. And that was a very unsafe rejoin, it must be said, as Phil Schlotter comes out of the pits now. How's this, though, for a fun fact? Well, fun fact. I think it's fun for everyone up until third position, because everyone up until fourth position has now been lapped. So, Stephen Bailey with some crazy pace. And the racing seems to have calmed down slightly. I mean, after having nearly an hour and a half of flat-out action. And as I say that, you've got Kvyat trying to get around Russo, but of course that's to put him a lap down. So the only action we're seeing right now is
in the pits.
In the pit lane.
Adam Hodgkinson and Lukasz Lakowicz, both in pits at the moment.
Yeah, and this could... They're both in Porsches, so battle of the Porsches there. Of course, Adam Hodgkinson, the second quickest Porsche of the race so far. Well, I wonder if something's happened to Damir Dubaric, because he has now been put three laps down, and, well, he wasn't this far down earlier on. Something must have happened between now and... must have been, what, 20 minutes ago when he was ahead of even April Dillon.
Yeah, April Dillon back to 17th now from the last position.
Yeah, and Stefan Woudenberg's been demoted all the way to second last. I wonder what's happened there. Max Simpson
still has
also been demoted.
Stefan Woudenberg still without a front wing there. I think pit crew didn't get that right. And just as a comparison, I have the
And I have the speed trap on at the moment, and Stefan Woudenberg with a top speed of 255.7 kilometers per hour,
wow,
which is 5 kilometers per hour slower than Stephen Bailey.
Wow, so that front splitter definitely makes a difference. Oh, hang on, they're both in different cars, so that could be the difference right there. Never mind.
That could be, yeah.
Oh, Anders Nielsen now in the pits with his Ferrari. Oh, sorry, he's leaving the pits, should I say. Very, very lengthy pit stop
and
today.
I
wonder who hired these pit crews, because they seem to be doing a very slack job.
And I have to say, give out a special thank you to Gerald Jacobson. He's just watching and just wrote in the chat. This is the guy who made this plugin real. The only thing I did about it is I changed the style of it a bit with some other colors that are better for race department. So thank you, Gerald, for this amazing plugin, even though it has some small difficulties with it, but everything can be sorted out. So heads up and thank you.
And okay. Oscar Hardwick has actually been able to close the gap down by 3 seconds. I don't think he'll be able to close down a full 50-second gap before the end of the race, unless...
3 seconds and 4 minutes. In about 4 minutes, he got 3 seconds. So... will be difficult to close it completely. Oh, and there was a small hit! A big hit! Not a small hit, a big hit! With,
that must have been Russo.
Stefan Woudenberg there.
Oh, was it? I think
nope, it
Russo
wasn't.
Was
no, it wasn't.
Car?
Was it Russo? No, it wasn't
I'm
Russo.
Not too sure, there was a red Ferrari.
Ah, it was Roman Gully.
Roman Gully. So, some more action going on there, but between two.
Let's just
cars.
Review that in a replay. Oh, he just spun and almost spun in the first corner. Just got back onto the track and hit Stefan Woudenberg there in the back.
Ah, that's. Silly stuff, you're supposed to wait for the cars to come through. Davey
he had no chance, he was still turning. He tried to brake there, but it didn't work out.
Ah, that's unfortunate, I mean, but that is something that we've been seeing. It's a growing trend for this race. We have seen that happen quite often. But Davey van der Ven, in and out of the pits very quickly, and still no repairs to the front of his car. Still, 19 guys out of 23 are still classified in this race. Nothing to sneeze at. This is a very competitive grid. Oscar Hardwick, another second that he's catching Stephen Bailey. But he's got Christian Michel just a minute and 15 seconds behind him. And Michel's got Kivela about half a straight behind him. So he needs to be careful. Oh, apologies. I got disoriented yet again. The other side of the circuit looks very, very similar to the front straight. And Stefan Woudenberg back into the pits. I think that must be his fourth pit stop or something.
Well, we can check that.
That damage must be doing nothing special for him. Roman Gully's still in the pits there. Kivela up in fourth. Still trying to catch Christian Michel. He needs to negotiate his way around some traffic in a couple of moments.
And everyone but the third and second has been lapped now by Stephen Bailey. So
that is very, very good. Oh, while we are sitting here, I was talking about Christian Michel having to negotiate through traffic. This traffic is actually for eighth position. This is Adam Hodgkinson versus Phil Shillito. And how do we miss this? This is the closest battle on the track at the moment, and Shillito is... looks to be catching Hodgkinson, and he's going to let Michel go right past there, adhering very nicely to the blue flags. We'll see if Hodgkinson does the same. Look at how loose the rear end of Hodgkinson is there. Same thing we've been seeing from Stephen Bailey, so... Tires are obviously very difficult to manage here. And Stefan Woudenberg just comes out of the pits behind the leader, Stephen Bailey. And Oscar Hardwick got to get it or negotiate his way around some more lap traffic. I'm just trying to find if there are any other battles apart from the Hodgkinson and Shillito one. Well, in fact, that's not even a battle anymore after the leaders were coming through. And Hodgkinson getting very sideways ahead of Christian Michel. So yeah, his tires are going to give up soon. Wow, he's not giving the lapping car much room there. He has to be careful of that, because if he doesn't adhere to the blue flags, he will incur a penalty. Whoa, and he just misses Christian Michel. But Hodgkinson's now falling into the hands of Shillito.
By the way, at the moment, April Dillon is on the 15th place, right behind Fabian Russo. Yeah. And she tries to attack there, I think. She's attacking, and nice.
Very
good attempt there, good attempt.
Nice and clean.
Yeah, nice driving there.
Very nice driving from April Dillon. Well, she will be immensely hacked off that she had made that mistake so early on after running. I think she was in the top five. So
right at the moment, Stephen Bailey in pits.
Oh, Stephen Bailey
just got released. Yeah, he's not going to make it.
I wonder if he had a stop and go penalty for something. Maybe he had done too many cuts or something, or... No, he wouldn't have had a botched pit entry because he had, he hasn't pitted, so he can't have had a, couldn't have messed up.
Yeah, but still 20 seconds, so this was a pretty fast stop if it was a stop.
So I wonder if he had just done either a splash and dash, so he'd either just taken some fuel, or if he had only opted to change tires, and he's running with just one tank of fuel. I think he actually might be running with just one set of tyres for the entire race. And
just had to refuel a bit for this last 20 minutes.
Yeah, exactly. But I think that gives Oscar Hardwick a very good chance now of closing that gap. Because if he's on really worn tyres in a heavy car, Oscar Hardwick has no trouble catching him. I mean, look at that. Oscar's just pulled 4 seconds in one sector. So that 18-second gap might fall very, very quickly.
That's still 20 minutes to go.
Yep, and let's hope it's going to be a very interesting 20 minutes for the lead of this race, at least. And Davidovich has got nobody following him. Sorry, I thought that Stedin was on the back of Davidovich there, but in...
And Adam Hodgkinson... Adam Hodgkinson just was off track. I think he parks his car at the side. I don't know what happens there.
He's parked his car for sure, but... Oh, he's DNF'd.
He has just DNF'd. Let's review that.
Now goes through into eighth place, but Hodgkinson,
he's going for the first corner. Oh, missed his braking spot. Barely missed.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Barely missed one car there and just stopped it.
Yep, and he's subsequently left the server. We've now got X Simpson in the pits. That's unfortunate, Adam Hodgkinson, but again, we've seen that kind of thing happen all too often.
X-Simpson, also DNF, just was in the pits and now has a DNF.
He DNF'd as well, that's... I wonder what's
pretty
going on.
Strange, I don't know.
Again, in the space of one lap.
And April Dillon now on position 12 again.
Woohoo!
She's really working her way up to the top there.
Yeah, oh, more interesting though. Is Oscar Hardwick closed down another 4 seconds just on that last lap to Stephen Bailey. This is going to get very, very interesting. Well, trying to look through for a battle, but of course the one between Shillito and Hodgkinson falls short, with Hodgkinson DNFing. However, they're still a lap ahead of Dubarich and Woodenburg. So those two need to be careful that they don't fall out of the race. And as I say that, Woodenburg very nearly puts himself out of the race by spinning.
By the way, Alexi Kivela just unlapped himself during the pit stop.
Sorry, I have to interrupt you. Davy van der Ven down the front straight, going past Fabio Russo.
I just see that at the moment.
Good move, good move. And with a damage car on the list, Russo is going to come back to him.
262.2 kilometers there. Top speed from Davy van der Ven.
Oh, wow, that's I think that's the quickest we've had so far. And Hardwick and Bailey, that gap seems to have stabilized. It's still sitting at about 16.5 seconds. So maybe Hardwick has lost his rhythm a bit, or Stephen Bailey has found some more life out of those tires.
Also, Franklin Stegging and Alexi Kivela, they saw a gap now since the pit stop. Looks like Stegging can't compete with him any longer.
Yeah, I think Stegging's just going to play this out like you should play in endurance, and wait for Kivela to maybe make a mistake, or maybe Stegging saving some tires to go for the last 10 minutes to just go absolutely crazy with his pace. Of course, not long to go until the end of this race.
And Oscar Hartwig is slightly closing the gap on the high 15-second gap here now. Half a second he got closer to Stephen Bailey at the moment.
Yep, so I think Stephen's still on the same tires as he was, and Oscar is on slightly fresher rubber and a slightly lighter car, so we'll have to see how this plays out towards the end of the race.
And April Dillon, back to 13th position at the moment.
I wonder what happened to her then.
She was at 14th position and just overtook Fabio Russo. I just saw that.
Oh, sorry. I thought she was higher than that. I thought she had dropped.
She was on 12th position before, but I don't know what happened there.
Maybe she.
Let's review that. Fabio Russo just made a mistake, went too far to the outside, and April just got a clean pass through there. The moment everything seems to settle down a bit, as Oscar Hartwig is closing the gap to 14.5 seconds. This can be pretty close.
This is going to be
the end of the race.
Close. However,
still 13 minutes ago, ahead.
Christian Michel has, it must be said that he's made a great drive, although he's not fighting for first position. He's made a very, very good recovery, so to speak, get himself back onto the final spot of the podium, albeit with a couple of mistakes from the guys who were in fact ahead of him. But you know, this Virtual World Series Moreno champion showing his worth, but the damaged car still in the final podium position. Oh, and as he just gets past Russo there, that was close. As, race seems to have mellowed out quite a lot now. Apart from Oscar Hardwick still catching Stephen Bailey, this race is, mellowing out, like I said, quite a bit. as Miroslav Davidovich now gets put two laps down after he was in third position for a few laps.
Yeah, I think we'll follow Oscar Hardwick for one lap in his cockpit view just to review the track for us here. Just over the start finish straight into the first two corners. It's right and left hander.
He comes into the double right hander complex. Still in the old GP circuit, heading down into the right hander. Of course, in the 2014 version, you would take a left hander into the chicane. Sorry, the chicane would go into the left. Oh, he's scrubbing his tires a lot. Still part of the old GP circuit here, all the way up until sector 2 is where it changes. So you're going to be heading into sector 2 about now, I think, just under the bridge. And you'll see how the whole complex has changed here from the 2007 GP circuit to the 2013 circuit. Got a nice, tight right-left sequence, and then another really tight 90-degree right-hander. And it really opens itself up now. Ooh, and Hardwick goes very wide. Whoa, and nearly spins. That's close. But anyways, you really open up the gas down here, and you want to brake as late as you can. And you've got a very tight right-hander open. You just got to turn in as soon as you see the, the edge of the apex, so to speak. And then a very tight double left-hander sequence into the second to last corner, and then a long right-hander sweep onto the main straight. Very, very nice technical layout of the Indianapolis circuit. I think I enjoy this one a little bit more than in the 2014 layout. Of course, the 2014 layout does have that awesome chicane where you can go bouncing over those curbs. And the 2007 layout, the old GP layout with its older sort of last sector complex, I think this one's a little bit nicer since it's a little bit more technical, a little bit more suited to the way these cars can drive. And of course, we mustn't forget, this layout was in fact built so that sports cars could race at the circuit better than they could at the 2007 layout. Oh, look at Oscar Hardwick. Ninja moves there to try and keep that car in a straight line. Clearly his tires are not happy with him. He's completely bullying them. You can see just how hard he's fighting. He wants that. He's now got the gap down to 13 seconds from Stephen Bailey. Not long to go. I think only 20 minutes left.
No, it's 9 minutes 40 left.
Oh, sorry, I apologize. 9 minutes for Oscar Hardwick to close the gap on Stephen Bailey. He's got some traffic to negotiate through, though.
Dami Dobarić at the moment in the pits gets him back to 17th position.
Yep. And
Stefan Woudenberg now in 16th.
17 classified drivers at the moment, so.
Yep.
That's 17 out of 23. Not a super impressive number of classified. Well, it's not really the end of the race yet, but. Not too impressive, but not unimpressive, I must say. And Bailey still negotiating his way around some of this lap traffic. Still not having an easy time of doing it. And this is going to slow him right down, and this is going to give Oscar an advantage. He should be in some clearer air once he gets around Stedging and close that gap even more.
And there still is a battle on at the moment. We have one battle. Yuri Kastrup is pretty close to Lukas Lakovic at the moment.
Oh, he's closing the gap, it seems. And Lakovic is bullying his tires, so either his tires are giving out and he's trying to overcompensate for the lack of grip he's feeling, or he's just bullying those tires and he's going to lose the grip that he's already got. And he will fall victim to Yuri if he's not careful. And of course, how can you say this, that this mod is unbalanced? You've got a Porsche in first, you've got a Corvette in second, you've got an Aston Martin in third, and then you've got a Ferrari in fourth. I mean, come on. Unbalanced? Nah. Oh, and Aslakovic locking up into turn one. That is not going to help you, my friend. You will be overtaken.
By the way, Damir Dubaric, DNF.
Oh, so now we're down to 16 classified drivers. Quite a few DNFs, and a lot of them were very strange. I know earlier on, when we had three guys
And another lockup from Luka Aslakovic here. As he was going through to that left-hander, and Yuri Kasdorp is now directly behind him.
We'll see if Yuri can make a move on this lap, or maybe on the next lap he might be setting himself up, have a run down on the main straight, and then he can execute an overtake.
And now the gap is getting bigger, and Oscar Hartwig at the moment, 9 seconds! The gap is as close to 9 seconds.
And of course, there's only a few laps left for him to try and make a charge, and he will definitely be pushing. And I'm actually watching him now, and he's pushing really, really hard.
As well as Luka Aslakovic, he had another lockup here on the entrance of this right-hander in the last section of the track.
Yeah, I think his tires have given up, and he's now trying to overcompensate for the lack of grip he's got. And, well, that's just going to end up hurting you more than it will be saving you. He will almost indefinitely fall victim to Yuri Kasdorp at the end of this race. Oh, I just hear bumpers bumping. Someone spin?
I just heard that too, but I have at the moment...
I don't see anything.
I'll just try to review it.
Oh, Kasdorp right on the grass. And he's going to try and overtake Aslakovic. He's right on the back of him now. And this is exactly what I said that would happen if he carried on bullying those tires. Look at the difference in pace between these two now. Look at the exit speed from Kasdorp as opposed to Aslakovic. Kasdorp definitely has the upper edge here. He's going to line himself up. And down either on the next straight or on the main straight, he will try and line up a pass. But he does look to be very impatient. Oh, and he doesn't get the pass. It's not close enough, but he definitely trying down the main straight. He needs to get a very good exit. Oh, and Aslakovic made a mistake. Ran wide, and that's going to hurt your exit. Kasdorp now going to go around the outside, I think. See if he can make it stick. How late can he break? Not late enough.
No, oh,
but
no.
Aslakovic locks up, and
this just touched two of
them. No way, guys, come on. Kasdorp just closing the door too quickly on Aslakovic, and well, spinning himself around. Oh, and he's now trying to run Aslakovic wide. That's not going to work, guys. He does, in fact, run him wide. Yeah. Usually ends in tears, and it did. But Bailey on a charge to try and win this race, still not long to go at all. But Oscar Hardwick with a monumental drive to close the gap from what, 20 seconds down to just 7 in the space of, I think it was almost 10 laps now. So stellar effort. Oh, it's now down to 5 at 5.8 seconds. So could Oscar Hardwick grab the win from Stephen Bailey?
It's only 2 minutes left, so I think last two laps are gone now.
This is going to be very close, provided Oscar does not get held up by traffic. May be able to snag the win. Both of these drivers deserve it. Both have driven exceptionally well. And some real classy, stellar racing from these two boys. Good to see. And this is all that the race department clubs are about. The sheer competitiveness, yet the friendly nature of the way that you can race with these guys is all that the race department clubs are about. And Shilito needs to get out of the way here of Hardwick. If he is to, and he does in fact do that. Oh, Hardwick with a slight cut to avoid making contact with Shilito. So Hardwick might go under review after this race. He has made more than just a couple of mistaken cuts. Hopefully that's not the case though, because he has had an impeccable drive.
3.8 seconds at the moment. The gap between Oscar Hardwick and Stephen Bailey, and only one lap to go.
This is the final lap. Stephen Bailey versus Oscar Hardwick. Who's your money on right now? Does Bailey succumb to the pressure and Hardwick win the race? Or does Hardwick come with some super heroic driving skills to take the lead from Stephen Bailey? Or do they end just as they are? Stick around, because you're going to want to know how this race finishes. And I wonder if we can just stay with Stephen Bailey here until he crosses the line. He does have Davidovich on his tail, not letting go of him, even though he's, what, two laps down only. Davidovich was in third earlier on, so...
And you can see in the back, there's Oscar coming, only 2.5 seconds is the gap at the moment, so... But I think Stephen Bailey will win this race here.
Well, let's not speak too soon. Anything can happen. This is virtual motorsport.
Even in real motorsports, you can't say that.
However, Stephen Bailey,
1.7 seconds
right on him. It's Stephen Bailey with an absolutely incredible drive, led most of this race, rounds the final corner. Just a mere 1.7 seconds ahead of Oscar Hardwick to take the win here in the first EGT Club race at Race Department. And Oscar Hardwick comes in a well-deserved third position. Congratulations to these two. Brilliant, brilliant racing. And Christian Michel going to round the final couple of turns now to come in third position. Or at least we hope he does. We'll see Christian Michel come over the line, third position. And I'm sure Stephen Bailey's going to be ecstatic at win. Brilliant, brilliant driving. And now Christian Michel comes across the line, takes third place. After being bumped down earlier on into seventh, made a brilliant recovery drive to get himself up there again.
So the last cars are going to come over the start-finish line now. Alexi Kivela in 4th, Theo Vandenbrink, April Dillon and Fabio Rosso are still on track.
Yeah. However, this should be where everyone finishes. So, the final standings, Stephen Bailey in 1st position. Oscar Hardwick, after starting in pole position, finishes in 2nd. Christian Michel finishes exactly where he started in 3rd position. Alexi Kivela, the Virtual World Endurance Championship champion, finishes in 4th after qualifying way, way down in the grid. And Franklin Stejink in 5th. Yuri Kuzdorp in 6th. Luka Oslakovic in 7th. He could not hold off Yuri Kuzdorp. Theo Vandenbrink in 8th. Miroslav Davidovic will be kicking himself after finishing in 9th after making a slight error and throwing himself out of third position. Paul Scioletto in 10th, rounding out the top 10, it must be said. That's nothing to sneeze at here at Race Department. Anders Nielsen in 11th. Davy van der Ven, slightly lower down than he would have expected in 12th. April Dillon, way lower down than she would have expected in 13th, after making a massive error, it must be said, in her own terms, down into turn 1. Then Roman Gali in 14th. 15th, Fabio Russo. 16th, Stefan Vordenburg. And he is, in fact, the last of the classified runners starting the declassified field, the DNFs, so to speak. In 17th, Damir Dubaric. In 18th, Adam Hodgkinson. 9th, X Simpson. In 20th, Henry Blake. In 21st, Shell Stenbeck. 22nd, Matt Richards. And in 23rd place, Magnus Stahlgren. So, Ricardo, this was an
absolutely amazing race.
Exactly. And well, ooh, as the session goes into the next, I don't know what race these guys want to go into, but server seems to be
restarting at the moment.
Yeah, restart session thing. But yeah, this race was interesting throughout. There was never a time where there wasn't at least some action out on circuit. And, well, what a brilliant introduction to the EGT mod and to the Indianapolis Motor Speedway provided to us by both United Races
Racing Design
and Image Space Incorporated here. Some brilliant content from those two developers. And look at the kind of racing this has provided us with. Really, really awesome stuff.
Yeah. So, I think we'll see much of this again in the next races. I want to thank you, Xavier, for being my co-commentator for tonight. I really appreciated it.
Of course, and a big thank you goes out to you and to Race Department for organizing this event, and to you for accompanying me here, both as an administrator and as a co-commentator. It was a truly pleasurable experience.
Yeah, so thank you to the audience who are still watching. And I think we'll see us again in a few days. I think next Friday or Saturday will be the next event. I don't know exactly after we look for it. So thank you and see you in a bit.